Hey everybody, this week on the Inked12, we're taking a look at a custom ink for Dromgoole of Houston, Texas. This is Noodler's USS Texas. So, as is the case with any Noodler's ink, it comes in a nondescript white box, which serves two purposes. One, to help keep the ink in one piece, and two, to let you know whether or not your bottle leaked all over. As you can see, my 3-ounce bottle managed to arrive in one piece. On the box, we've got a sticker with a nice motif of the USS Texas. And on the left flap, we've got the contact phone number for Dromgoole themselves. Now, one thing I like about these bottles, they're very hardy glass 3-ounce bottles. But beware, Nathan does like to fill these bottles to the top, so when you open them, make sure you're doing it on the flat surface, and same thing when you're filling it, make sure you're filling on the flat surface as well. Now, for the writing review, we're going to go ahead and use this orange Pilot Custom 74 that I also got from Dromgoole. This particular Custom 74 does have a broad nib, which I'm starting to think is a trend. And I did use the standard Con 70 that comes with the pen, which, yes, I actually think the Con 70 is their best converter. Now, let's go ahead, get everything out of the way, and take a look at the writing sample, which, once again, we've done in our Endless Works Pen Chalet Edition Tomoe River Paper Notebook. So, let's go ahead and see how this ink performed. As you can see, it's a very nice shading, dark teal, well, light teal to dark teal, with a little bit of green thrown in, but it does take forever to dry, as you can see there with the ink drops. Now, let's go ahead and take a look at the close-ups so we can get a little bit of a better idea of how USS Texas performs. As I was saying earlier, it's a really nice-looking teal that has a good flow to it. I didn't have any starting issues with the broad nib in the 74. Now, I also didn't have any issues with feathering. I know we're looking at Tomoe River, which if you feather on Tomoe, you're doing it wrong. But even on the Rhodia sample that I used for the water test, which we'll see later, it behaved very well. Now, there was one issue though, and that's with dry time. On Tomoe, I found it took over a minute for the ink samples to dry, and even on Rhodia, it took over 30 seconds. And most inks tend to dry quickly on Rhodia, so that's kind of a problem in my book. Speaking of Rhodia though, let's go ahead and move on to the water sample. As you can see here, I wasn't lying when I said it was very well behaved on Rhodia. With a lot of Noodler's inks, it's commonplace to see some feathering, or a lot of feathering if you're talking about House Divided, but USS Texas doesn't have any of those problems that I can see here. Aside from that aside, let's go ahead and bring in the water and our syringe to go ahead and see how USS Texas handles a little bit of a spill. I still haven't replaced that syringe, and it's sticking a little bit more and more each test. But as you can see, we went ahead and mimicked a small water, coffee, tea, whatever spill you want to call it. And you can see the blue portion of the ink lifting from the paper. So definitely not waterproof, but with the performance I'm seeing here, it's safe to say that USS Texas is pretty water resistant, which is another tick in the pro column for me. So now that it's had a few moments to sit, let's go ahead and wipe the test page down with a microfiber cloth to go ahead and get some of the standing water slash ink off the page. You can already see a lot of the blue and teal are just coming right up off the Rhodia onto the cloth. And surprisingly, not a lot of it got on the table, but I wanted to go ahead and clean off my desk. Looking at the paper, this is a really good performance from the Noodler's ink. It's extremely legible, and other than losing the color, it held up really well. I mean, the paper is probably going to fail before the ink itself. So now that we've seen the writing sample, now that we've seen the water sample, where does that put us as far as overall thoughts for Noodler's ink USS Texas? On one hand, it's got a really nice color. I'm a fan of blue inks primarily, but this is a really nice dark teal. And with how well it behaves, the color just shows so well. And going back to the behavior of the ink for a second, this ink actually flows very smoothly. Even after not being used for quite a while. In this particular case, I had not written with this pen for about a week and a half after I'd come back from Arizona. And considering the first things I'd written were the writing sample and the water sample, you could see that I wasn't having a hard starting issue at all. And another good thing about this Noodler's ink is the price point. Nathan does a pretty good job making sure that most Noodler's inks clock in at under $15. So for an ink that's got a good color, good flow, no hard starting issues, and a good price, and also has good water performance, that's really good. But I mean, it's not perfect, and you already know where I'm going with the one con for this ink, and that's that it takes forever to dry, regardless of what paper you use it with. I mean, I even used it on cheap office paper at work, and the dry times on that were worse than what we're seeing here. And look at the word price. That was smearing after about, what, 30, 35 seconds? In my books, that's a pretty big con. So when we stack it together though, even though it's a pretty big con, it's something that, personally for me, I find a little forgivable because I'm not always writing in a fast-paced scenario. So I can give it an 8.5 out of 10, which I did here, but you may find yourself rating it more at about a 5.5 to 6 if you write in a faster-paced environment. So does that mean you should go out and buy this ink? Well, that's up to you. If you like teal, and you actually like a Noodler's ink that behaves for a change, give it a try. Head on over to Dromgoole's and pick a bottle up for yourself. So if you liked the video, don't forget to hit that like button, and leave a comment down below if there's a particular ink that you'd like to see done on the channel. Also, if you're new to the channel, hit that subscribe button, and follow the channel on Twitter and Instagram, at The Inked Well. And if you want to help buy some coffee or some ink or whatever the case may be, support the channel over at patreon.com/theinkedwell. That's going to do it for this week. I'll see you next time.